Listen to me, Morty. I know that new situations can be intimidating. You're looking around, and it's all scary and different. But, you know, meeting them head-on, charging into them like a bull, that's how we grow as people. Rick Sanchez.
If you're not scared, you're not taking a chance. And if you're not taking a chance, then what the heck are you doing? Ted Mosby.
You're 18 years old and off to college in just a few months. Time to figure this stuff out. You only learn by trying. May the force be with you. This is your dad, Andrew Douglas.
Good morning.
Good morning.
My name is Margot Douglas. I want to take you all back, almost 8 years back. I was 10, definitely younger than I should have been before I even thought about the grave decision of swimming to the infamous quag buoys on the Long Island shore. Not only to swim, but perform the triangle. What is the triangle, you may ask? It is meant for the most advanced swimmers only. Something my 10-year-old chubby self was certainly not. Not only must you reach the first buoy, but you must go around the second before returning to the safe shore. The risk, sharks, rip currents, and lifeguards far too inexperienced to save you. The reward, ultimate glory throughout the quag community. I begged my mother to go with me, knowing she was bigger than I was and would most likely be eaten first. She, of course, refused, but somehow allowed me to traverse into the dangerous depths of Long Island. I picked the next best victim, my friend Claudia, who I knew I could outswim if it came down to the worst case scenario. We waded into the crashing waves that loomed over us, feeling prepared for the challenge ahead. What made me feel ready for the worst? The words, because I can. Because I can has been a part of my life since the day I was born. My dad keeps two silver coins in his pocket, one for me and one for my sister. Each have our initials on one side and the letters B-I-C inscribed on the other. These words have not only helped me begin one of the most grueling tasks on earth, but they have helped me survive Westminster, which at times can be a very scary place, especially when standing in front of the entire school, either when I sing, act, or right now. I was a new sophomore, yearning for friends as most new sophomores do, and I decided to try out for the winter musical, The Little Mermaid. As many of you can assume, theater has been a part of my life for a long time. But the truth is, every performance scares the crap out of me. I did not expect much when I tried out, and when I opened the email from Mr. Rashid saying I'd been cast as Ursula, I may or may not have broken down into merciless sobs. You see, my Westminster sophomore self brought out a bit of a chicken in me. I was terrified, more terrified than I'd ever been, even including my daring, possibly shark-filled, triangle experience in quag. The rehearsals were not much better for my confidence. Mr. Rashid and Mr. Kriz would push me to act like an evil sea creature, but the best I could do seemed to be similar to Maggie McCarthy trying to be mean. They told me to growl, hiss, and sneer at the actors and the audience, but growling like an evil psychopath in front of 300 people? No, thank you. Also, Ursula's songs were too low for my voice, so I was basically talking like a man the entire show, and my two backup eels were seniors who petrified me. I'm not going to explain my entire rehearsal process as Ursula, but the worst part of the whole thing was the costume. My entire face was painted purple, and I wore a huge white spiky wig and a dress that had 8 tentacles sewn onto it, doubling my weight. I felt like a complete idiot when I tried to naturally strut across the stage in bright purple platformed boots. In late February, the performance came around, and I was completely freaked again. I stood backstage, and I could hear my heart pounding in my chest, sweat dripping all over, and my legs quivering so badly it made it difficult to even walk, with or without tentacles. I couldn't stop thinking about everyone, the whole school in the audience, my fellow cast members. I worried they would think of me as the stereotypical theater girl when all I wanted to do was fit in on the social radar. But just as I had been trained to do, I took a breath and recited the words, "Because I can." Just as I had done when I was 10 and so many times before. It's not like these words have magical powers, although my dad may disagree. But they allowed me to believe I could stand up tall, even as a short, evil, ridiculously purple sea creature. Today, I carry these words to remind myself that I can do what I enjoy without everyone else's thoughts consuming me. I look back on my sophomore self, wishing I knew that when I perform, 90% of the community feels pretty indifferent to my actions, and some may even enjoy watching me on stage. I even remember after that performance hearing one of the senior boys thought I looked cute in the musical. Sorry, Newt. These days, I look back at those two buoys sometimes when I sit on the beach. About 100 yards away from shore, maybe less, honestly, completely sharkless and completely safe. I can see how much I have changed from when I was 10 to 15 to now. I did not make it to those buoys when I was 10. I barely made it halfway. As Ursula when I was 15, I pushed myself to confidently go on stage, but definitely not without a mental fight. Now, I stand here in front of all of you, excited to share the words, "Because I can." With 5 weeks left on campus, I find myself looking around thinking of my legacy in this community. Will I always be remembered as the girl who tromped around on stage in a ridiculous Ursula costume? Maybe. But I hope all of you can find your motto. Find the words you need to hold on to when you need an extra push. When you feel as if you look like a giant purple sea creature in an overbearing costume. Am I still scared when I get in front of an audience? 100%. But at least I know I can get through it, standing tall, proud of myself for even getting up to try. I hope all of you spend your time at Westminster, putting yourselves in a place of discomfort, or even in a situation where there's a chance you might mess up. You might just learn something from it. Why? Because you can. Thank you.
Yeah.